Hey, what's up? Kris Krohn here. I've been living in mansions for the last 15 years, but I haven't been the one paying for it. In fact, my entire lifestyle, from the cars that I drive to the places around the world I go with my wife, my kids.
This is very awesome.
It's all covered by a really basic investment strategy that I'm going to be teaching you today. How do you actually buy homes without needing money? How do you buy homes without needing credit? Anytime you want to add to your lifestyle, you need to learn to think, how do I buy an asset that pays for more of what I want? So one of the reasons why my wife and I moved out here, you know, hashtag mountain life, is we love the seclusion. We love the privacy. I love the trees. I come originally from Washington, so trees are like crazy important to me. But aside from that, it's a really safe community. It's gated, it's got a really great fitness facility. My buddies, we get together and we do some crazy, crazy lifting. One more! One more!
Come on, ready for more!
Just about every single morning, loving on that. And then it's got a pool. And we use that every single day with our kids. It is literally a source of just nonstop fun. Dude, I gotta tell you, I love this house. It's like it was built for me and my family. It's literally been like the most perfect, amazing place all around. All right, man, home sweet home. So this is Beast meets Sexy Beast. I'm a huge German automobile fan, and the moment they came out with an i8 convertible was super important to me. I had to get one. That's my bay where my parents normally park. They're out right now. My parents actually live with me. When I was a kid, it was a goal of mine, even though I had 8 other brothers and sisters, that I wanted to take care of them when they got older. And so about 10 years ago, I retired my parents, and it's been actually one of the great blessings of my life, actually having them here with me and their 4 grandchildren. What's up, love? Okay, now I get to introduce you to literally the most important person in the world. This is Kalen. This is my woman of 19 years. I love her to pieces. We've got 4 kids.
Hi, guys.
And this is her domain, especially in here, because heaven knows I can't cook anything. When we bought this house, like what I loved the most about it was this.
The windows.
It brings in so much nature. Like I think right then and there, we're both like, yep, we'll take it.
Yeah, that was my favorite thing about the house.
Which was cool because, by the way, even when I bought this house, guess what? I still didn't use a bank to buy it because of the things that I'm about to teach in this video. Honey, I want to talk to them about our first house because part of what we're doing here is showing them that this amazing lifestyle that we have is really paid for by everything that we have. Like this room right here, we seriously could probably put our first house in this room. It was.
Yes, we could.
It was tiny.
Yep. It was tiny and gross.
And it was gross.
At first.
And it smelled.
And it smelled really bad.
A lot.
And I wasn't gonna live in it unless the smell was gone.
My wife, by the way, she was such a trooper because she was so nervous. You were like—
It was so bad.
She totally said, okay, Kris, I'm gonna go with you on this. I know you're getting advice from your real estate mentors, but
please don't
screw this up. And not only that, but she was terrified to be that young and owning a house. And
yeah, I was 21.
Yeah. So here's the deal on this house. Here's what was cool about it. I found this house, this old little bungalow that was worth 150 grand. And by working with my mentors, I figured out how to buy this house for $110,000, which meant that it was worth $150,000. I got it for $110,000. It was $40,000 below market. But there was something cool. It had this basement apartment that after renting would literally pay for the entire upstairs. Like the upstairs was 3 bedrooms. The downstairs was one.
One and a little kitchen. And we were able to rent that for $500. And I remember our mortgage was like $508.
Yeah, so it was super awesome because it paid for everything. And that first house is what literally led to the next 25 that got us to about a $12,000 a month residual.
That was our goal.
Yeah, that was that. Well, actually the first goal was if we can get to $10,000 a month, you said, Kris, you can quit your job.
Yeah.
And so the year I graduated college at BYU is the same year that I actually quit my job because we had a $12,000 a month income. And ever since, we've been living in these, you know, beautiful homes, world traveled, having children. We got 4 amazing kids. And so real estate has just started off by being a really tremendous blessing for us.
This is our dining room.
That we never use.
It's not true.
This is the kitchen that we use.
This is the kitchen.
All the time.
All the time. This is our daughter, Liesl. She's 14. Kaiser's 12. Livia is 10. Daniel is almost 9. They are beautiful and amazing and quirky and full of character, we'll just say.
Well, we're giving them a custom education. Like, currently they're not in school. We've hired a private professor to literally come in. We do a lot of our travel world studies around the world. And downstairs we actually have a school room because I want to customize their education. I want them to learn about business, entrepreneurship, the things that kids should be learning that they're not.
All right, here we've got a library. This is our son Kaiser's Lego project, 4,100 pieces. And he can put it together by himself in about 2 days. Yay! There you go. Isn't that cute?
Reading is super important in our family. This is one of my favorite spots in the house.
Let me show him. This is the magnet board. I made this board. This is so the kids can actually see our pictures instead of being stuck on our phone. I updated it probably 6 months ago, so it's got the last couple years worth of, you know, awesome places we've gone and things we've done.
When we first got married, we made this decision that we wanted to have enough money that we could give our kids and ourselves like the most amazing world experience. So we've been to Bora Bora. We've seen the pyramids in Egypt. We've been to Israel.
Disneyland,
yes. The Amazon, like, for us, it's all about exotic, right? Bali, Thailand, Cambodia.
And even Utah, because we live in Utah.
Utah's an amazing state.
Utah's awesome. There's our daughter. There's cool places to explore in Utah. So, okay, we're going to our room next.
This is our master bedroom. My favorite part, literally at midnight, is just lying here and staring out that window and having the city down in the valley. Like the lights of the city at night, they're amazing. Absolutely love them. The builder of this house did an immaculate job paying attention to every detail. For being this huge, massive house, it's actually fairly minimalistic. So the sizing of the rooms, the way it was put together, I love it. In here, I keep some of my favorite keepsakes. These are actually, Clint, do you remember some of these?
So oh, yeah.
We did a mission to Kenya.
This is from Africa.
And the man who gave this to me literally was attacked by a lion and had the back of his skull chunked out, defending like the goats.
This is from the Maasai tribe.
Yeah. This one's from Peru. All of the handcrafts.
Oh, this is
stuff.
Too.
Yeah, that's also, but that's actually Amazon Peru. That's highlands.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
That's deep in the Amazon. But dude, we got mementos here literally from all around the world. So sometimes I just feel like wearing all of my man bracelets.
Ooh,
and they represent places we've been all over the world.
You got that in Australia last year.
Yeah. You'll notice I have a whole bunch of watches. I hate watches. I haven't worn a watch for years. I think the watch keeps us non-present. Keeps us like anti-focused on what's important, and I hate them. And so when people come to my events, I smash them. It's a representation of financial freedom. Like, in fact, all of the things in this drawer are a huge reminder that real estate paid for us to go all over the world. Like the cars we drive, the life that we have, the food that we eat, the coaches, the mentors, you know, all the cool things that we do with our kids. It's literally all paid for by our investments. We don't have to work for that money to come in. Most people, the mistake that they make financially is that they are too busy working for money. Money is supposed to work for you. Now listen, this amazing lifestyle, it's not just because I bought that first house, it's because I bought many since. Let me tell you about my second house that I bought. This house was the next city over, and again, I didn't have money for it. Like, are you kidding me? What people save up thousands of dollars in their bank account and let it sit there? I didn't have that. Our first house meant we were living for free. Our first house meant that we were like getting ahead and getting out of debt. But you see, after I held that house for a little bit of time, I went to the bank and I said, "Bank, look at all that equity, give me some of it." And the bank basically said, "Sure, we'll do that through what's called a home equity line of credit." Now, I want you to listen up to what I want to share with you right now. I used that little bit of money, and it came from the house, but it could have come from a partner, it could have come from a parent, it could have come from a 401k, an IRA, it could have come from hard-earned savings, which I didn't have at the time because I was poor. In my case, it came from the house, and I basically said, you know what? If one house has treated us so well, then two should treat us twice as well. So I used that money in the house, and guess what? I bought my next house. Same thing, I bought it undervalued, and this time I was using a different strategy, because Clint, do you remember that house? We were not living in it. This was a house that for the first time was like what's called a non-owner occupied. My mentor said, Kris, there's this cool strategy called a lease option. And instead of just renting the house, we'll show you how to make two or three times as much money. You put a family in the house with a rent to own that actually wants to have the house and rent it and keep it. And so do you remember the family, Thurgoods?
Yeah, so I remember they put down a down payment.
They gave us $3,000.
And they were there like 10 years.
They were there for 10 years. And during that period of time, we were making $600 a month on this property. So by the way, at the end of the first year, we were totally out of debt, living for free, we had a fantastic cash flow, our net worth was well over $100,000. And anytime you want to add to your lifestyle, anytime you want more, you need to learn to think in a different way. You need to learn to think, how do I buy an asset like a home that pays for more of what I want? Kris, I want a Can-Am or a boat, or Kris, I want a bigger house. Like, understand that when we moved into our first 10,000 square foot home that I built custom right on the golf course outside the canyon, the house we had before this one, all of it was paid for because we had a goal. Basically, once we got those 25 homes, it paid for everything. And that's what you can do.
Welcome to our deck.
Kid you not, this was like the main selling feature, because for me, this is my office. Like, I work out here, or it's down in Hammock Island.
Or you grill here.
And it's just like a perfect 70, 75 every single day out here. And this is just a great place to hang. All right. By the way, this is a map of all of the places that we have been in the world. And we have a goal of seeing how many places?
100 countries in our lifetime.
Our travel's gonna be a little bit more domestic this year. All right, next on the Krohn family tour, the schoolhouse, right? Part of our lifestyle, part of what we have is having a place to educate and teach our children. We're on the road, we're taking planes. Normally, we're seeing the world, right? We were gonna take them to the Olympics, and we had spent a bunch of money on tickets to go see, like, seriously, our like gymnastics and taekwondo and some of our favorite things. But really, this is where life happens. This is where school happens on most daily basis. When we put our school together, we put a creed together of the 10 things that were most important to us: being conscious creators, our personal beliefs, work, service, responsibility, self-sufficiency. It was just a great opportunity for us to say, these children, they are my science experiments. I've got them for 18 years. What do I actually want to teach them? What makes this work so well, by the way, is the fact that we found the perfect teacher, a professor at a local university that we hired away and said, I want my kids to have this education. I want them to learn about this and this. And frankly, a lot of people looking at my life and like, Kris, it looks like you get everything that you want. It looks like you have it all, right? I even have a podcast that's called Have It All. And have it all doesn't mean like I'm a multi-billionaire and that I have everything. What it means is that anytime I want something, I know how to make it happen. In fact, here's the third thing that I would teach you in this video today is partnerships. How do you actually buy homes without needing money? How do you buy homes without needing credit? One of the reasons why I have this lifestyle is because I built an initial track record. The first few homes you buy, it is so important to do them right. You need a mentor. By the way, if you don't have one, click the link below and actually get with me and my team and learn about having me as your mentor guiding you through your first few deals. Because something magical happens once you have a track record on 2, 3, or 4 homes. People that you know come out of the woodworks and start saying, hey, you're doing something that's working. For me, that was my father-in-law. I had bought my third house. He thought I was kind of crazy when I bought my first few houses. But then he kind of caught on to this idea, this kid is up to something. Every time he buys a house, his net worth goes up way more than when I put money in a 401k. Every time he buys a house, he gets a cash flow. The stock market doesn't pay you a cash flow. And then I have all these tax advantages. So it was his idea. He came to me on my fourth house and said, you know what? What if we partnered up? I gave you the money. I'll leverage you to do the work. And you know what? That is when magic happened in my life. This is the armory. Get out alive. All right, all right.
this gun is really, really, really cool. I really like this one. It's super lightweight, accurate up to 1,000 yards. Works really well. I made this guy after a trip to Africa, and I think he's pretty freaking awesome. This is like a stress reliever for me. Taking animal skulls. This was a crocodile, this was a baby killer, and he no longer is. I certainly enjoy going out in nature, the shooting range, and I like a variety of guns because they all have their own merits. But you know what I really love? I love bow hunting. That really gets me going.
One thing about me is I love rocks, crystals, things like that, and I collect them. So I got this monster chunk of pyrite. It's from Peru over here. I've got, and you'll see, I've got rocks all over my house. This is my pretty amethyst crystal geode chunks from, I think they're from Brazil. This is my salt room. So it's actually made of Himalayan salt. And when we moved into this house, Kris built this for me because I like rocks and meditation. So this is kind of a meditation space. And then I collect rocks from all over the world. So you can see some of them. I love to travel and I love to pick up cool things. And it's really cool to see what God made. It's really awesome. I can turn this off and then see how it's backlit from behind. This is like my meditation space and it's super fun.
All right. Hands down at times, one of the most important rooms in the house. This is where me and all my buddies get together and chill. And we got the TV right here. So it's always good for a movie. But you know what? It's also good for some bro force. So here's what I want you to understand. The number one fallacy people have when it comes to building wealth is they think that they actually have to have the money to make money, or they think they need to have credit, or they need to be doing well enough in life. And you know what? I never believed that. How do I become a deal maker? In other words, if I can find a good deal, and if I can find a deal attractive enough that someone with money would want to do it, then guess what you're doing? You're putting deals with people with money. You become the partner, and for me in most situations, that's a 50-50 partnership. I mean, I have a team now of 200 experts that help me buy thousands of these homes that have really high ROIs, but something really cool for you to know about, I even have a way for you to partner with me without any money or any credit and actually buy real estate. That's also available in the link below so that you can get all of the tools that you need to crank it out and frankly create the lifestyle of your dreams. So this is Hammock Island. This is actually one of my favorite places to actually hang out or do business meetings or just chill. And here she comes. So we have a pretty crazy lifestyle. And so we need to like instantly know how to unplug. And everything that I've been sharing with you guys today about how I got here and how my lifestyle is supported by all my investing, I think I would give you this final advice. Your goals should not be about having like a certain amount of money. It's not about how rich you are. For me, it was never about that. I don't care what my net worth is. Who cares what that means on paper? What I care about is knowing, what do I want? What does it cost amortized on a monthly basis? And how do I pick up enough homes or other investments or active income that actually pays for all of that? And that really is the take-home lesson. Can you imagine being able to have anything that you dreamed about? I mean, within reason, right? Like it's not necessarily having like the Taj Mahal, but if you have goals and dreams that cost millions of dollars, that's really reasonable. Like for example, I just bought the lot next door and I'm working with my architect and we're designing this 10,000 square foot underground bunker. It's got like a room just for like paintball wars. It's got another room for underground deep racquetball. It's got a huge underground garden. It's got a 9-car garage. And the cool thing is I'm dreaming it up and of course I can have it because I'm sharing with you that once you know what you want, there's a monthly cost to actually own that thing now. You just need to do enough deals that actually covers that monthly cost. And once you have that, you can then have that lifestyle. So I've been able to increase my lifestyle. I've been able to have more and do more with time because all it means is do more deals. All you really have to learn how to do is a successful deal. And you only have to learn one way that it works. And if you can find one way that something works, you can do it again and again and again and again. One of my successful students in the last year and a half has bought 68 doors, 68 homes, each paying him money. And he found just one way that worked, and then he just rinses and repeats over and over and over again. And successful people, that's what they do. They don't reinvent the wheel. They don't have to keep thinking of new ways to do things. If you want more, or if you want different, or if you have a goal that's gonna take a lot more money, I don't think about the money. I just think, how many deals do I need to do? It takes me 20 hours to do a deal. I need to do 10 deals. That's 200 hours. Then I can have this really cool big thing that I want.
Hey, thank you so much for watching today's video. If you liked it, smash that like button. If you don't have a free income coach in your corner giving you your next steps for advice, click the link. My team will take care of that for you. And finally, if you are not a subscriber, take care of that right now.